You probably think that you know the non-volley zone rule and there's nothing left to learn about it. In this video, I'm going to show you why you really don't understand the non-volley zone rule and how you can use this new knowledge to help you play better pickleball. My name is Tony Roig. I'm a master teaching professional as well as a senior pro player. And together with my partner, CJ Johnson, we are two dedicated pickleball professionals dedicated to helping you improve your pickleball game. If you want to connect with us, I'll link to that below. All right, let's talk about the non-volley zone and why you don't understand the full context of the non-volley zone and how it can help you improve your play. Now, I've set up the camera over here for a reason. I want you to see the court the way you would if you were playing on this side. So you're gonna be this player throughout this video. You're looking at it like this. If you don't understand this non-volley zone, the one that I'm standing in right now, I'm gonna link to a video up here that'll explain this non-volley zone rule and how it applies to the game. So I would go to that video. This video is not for you. If you already understand this non-volley zone rule, keep watching because we're gonna talk about the entire non-volley zone so that you can understand how to use it to your advantage. So this non-volley zone that I'm standing in right now, from your vantage point, right, from here, is a negative, right? It's a limitation, it's a hindrance. It stops you from doing something. It limits your movement. It stops you, it's why you play here, right? Why don't you play the game here? The game here would be easier, right? You just slam the balls from here. You play from behind this line because of this non-volley zone rule. So, and from that vantage point, this non-volley zone is a hindrance. But there's a non-volley zone that you have to consider on the other side of the net. This non-volley zone. This non-volley zone is not a hindrance. Not only is it not to you, not only is it not a hindrance, it's designed for your benefit, right? The same way that this one's a hindrance to you, this one over here, the one on this side of the net is a hindrance to this player, to the player standing here, to your opponent. If you understand that, what you can do is you can use this area that I'm standing in here to your advantage. What happens is players sometimes, they reach a certain point in their development and then they kind of find this ceiling, right? I can't get past, or a wall, I can't get past it, I'm stuck. A lot of times what we find is that is a result of not understanding this area here on this side. So what happens is, say you're playing against me, I assure you that I understand that area, the one that hinders you. Let's assume that you don't understand how to use this side. We're playing an uneven game. We're playing a game that's frankly not fair to you, because I'm gonna take advantage of this zone, your non-volley zone. You will not take advantage of the one that is made for your benefit. So if you wanna look at it that way, I will take advantage of what we can call my non-volley zone, which is this one, the one designed for my benefit. You, however, don't know how to take advantage of this non-volley zone, the one designed for your benefit. Uneven game, because I'm gonna take advantage of this one. I'm gonna be able to use it to get myself out of trouble, right? You, however, don't know how to use this one to get yourself out of trouble. Let's talk a little bit about the uses of the non-volley zone, right? The one that's designed for your benefit, so you understand how to overcome this potential disadvantage when you're playing a player like me who understands how to use the non-volley zone on the other side of the net, my non-volley zone. What you want to do is you want to use this zone for a couple of things, but primarily they're the same thing. They are in order to reset the situation or to get yourself out of trouble. An easy example of that is the third shot drop. So the third shot drop is hit if you're standing on that side and you're the serve team and me and my partner up here at the non-volley zone line on our side. The way that you're gonna be able to get yourself up to your non-volley zone to move forward is to use this part of the court to accomplish that objective. Another example would be when I have you in trouble. So let's say we're in a sort of a dinking contest or we're up here working and I stress you, I pull you off the court, right? What shot should you use? If you hit it high to my partner or me, we're just gonna poke it and put it away, which is commonly what happens. But if you have an understanding of this zone here, think of it like home or safe when you played tag as a kid. Now you know, oh, I can use this zone here, this area here, to get myself out of that tough situation. And you can even think about it broader than that. Whenever you are in doubt, so you're in a situation that you don't know what to do. Say you're in a firefight, right? You're in a firefight, we're battling back and forth, and you think, you know, I'm kind of losing this shot, this proposition. You hit a nice block volley, you drop it in here. So in any of those situations, when you're in trouble or you're simply unsure as to what to do, what you can do is you can use this zone here and just say, you know what? Let me slow this thing down. This thing has gotten out of control. I don't like what's happening. I'm unsure as to what's happening. I'm gonna drop it in here. And by dropping in here, what you're doing is you're extending the rally. Think about it this way, you're living to fight another day or another shot. So using this zone is absolutely critical. But what you need to do before you do that is have a complete understanding of this side, a hindrance. This side, a benefit, something created for your game and to improve your game. So as you start to develop as a player or continue to develop as a player, what you'll wanna do is start using this zone more intentionally, use the zone with understanding its purpose, understanding it's built for you, and understanding you can use it anytime that you get yourself into trouble. If you start understanding that, you'll become the player that has the advantage, the unfair advantage, unfair in quotes, if you want to call it that, when you're playing against players that don't understand how to use this. You learn how to use this, advantage you. Have fun out there.